Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about how we can run a JDBC program. So to do this, we have to do two steps before typing our Java program, compiling and executing. So the first step is creating a database in any one of the backend application. Here we have chosen the Access as our application. So when we enter into the Access application, so first you can give file new, then you can see a blank option, blank database option. So here you can give a name as well as you can choose the location where the database file is going to be, and after that you can press the click button. So when press the create button, so when you use the create button, empty database file will be created. So you can see the skeleton of this. Now within this there is no table, so you can see in the left pane table followed by table 1. The table 1 is the default name for the first table. Now we can design our table using the design view. So you can right click the table option and then choose the from this pop up menu, you can choose the design view. Then the next screen comes. So here you can see a dialog box like this. So here you can give the name of the table. So the default table is table 1. Now we can choose the table as prod info. Since we are going to create a product information, you can change the table name as prod info and then click OK. Now after this you can see the screen. So this screen has you can see the table name is prod info table. Now you can see this area where you can create your fields. So the first field is ID field with for data type auto number. This is by default in all table it is you can see the first field as ID with the data type auto number. So this is created in all database table. So this will maintain the number of records in the table. So if you don't want this, you can remove it. Then after this we are going to create the following fields in our table. So the first field product name, so this is of text type. Then second one product ID, this is of number type. And then third field is quantity, fourth field is unit price, then total price. So here the first product name is only text. Then all the fields are of in number type. So if you want to choose a number type, there are different formats in number type. So if it is an integer, you can choose the long integer. By default it is a long integer, otherwise you can choose it as integer. Then for a floating point value, you can choose the type as double. So here how we can choose this double field. So here you can see the below this design window message window. So here shows the field properties. In this the first one is field size. Here you can view the type as long integer. At the end you can see a downward triangle symbol. If you click the downward triangle symbol, you can see a different formats. Then from that you can choose one of the format. Then if you choose a double precision format, then you can view, if you choose a double precision, then you can view a decimal places field here. So here also you can change it as using the downward triangle symbol. You can choose digits you have to see after the decimal point. Here we have chosen the number 2, so you can see 2 digits after decimal point. So now we can see the list of fields that we have designed. So the first product name, product ID, then quantity, unit price, total. So these are the fields that we have created. So in all the fields you can see just the type as number, but the description says only it is whether it is a integer type or double precision. So after using, after creating all the fields, then we can save the file. So this is very important step. So here you have to save the file type as access 2002-2003. So this format only you can get the access the data in our Java program. So this format is very very important. So you have to save the file as save as access 2002-2003 format. So you have to choose this format, and then so next you can see the pop-up menu. After giving the file save as, you can see the option. The first option says that you have to save all the, you have to close all the objects. So here you have to give the option as yes. Then second pop-up menu will come. So here this prompts you to save the changes. So here also you have to click yes button. So after giving this, you can get a dialog box. So here you have to give the name of the database. So in the very first screen also you have given the database name. If you want to save it in some other location with the format 2002-2003 format, then you can give the name of the file, database file. So here the database file is given as a prod.db, and this is the location. So we have saved the file in documents folder, and press the save button. The next step, so this is the first step to create our database table. So after creating a database file with the table, so database name is prod.db and the database table is prod.info. So after creating this, now we are moving on to the second step. So in the second step only we are going to map this database file with the data source name. So for this we have to move on to control panel. So in the control panel, so we have to choose the data source ODBC. So ODBC tool, which is available in the administrative tool. So you have to choose it. So data sources ODBC. Then after this, you can get a screen like this. So the first tab says that user DSN. So here only we are going to create a data source name. So here you can see list of data sources which are already available, and if you want to choose a new data source name, then we have to click this add button. So when you click this add button, then it will move on to the next screen. So here list of so next we have to move on to the list of drivers you have to choose. So the backend application that we choose is Microsoft Access. So the device, the database driver that you have to choose here is Microsoft Access driver. So within the parenthesis asterisk.mdb, there is another option also available. So you have to choose the first option, Microsoft Access driver asterisk.mdb. So after this, after choosing the driver name, then the next screen is like this. So here you have to give the data source name. Now I choose the data source name as my data source name, and here you can give any description. Below this you can choose the database. So here you have to select it, the database. So you are going to map the database name with this data source name. So you for connecting, that is for mapping this, so you have to select a database. So for this you have to click the select button, then the select button will move on to another screen. So here you have to choose a location where the file is available. So our file is available in documents folder. So documents in PC, which is in user folder of C drive. So you have to choose this database file. So from this location, so choose the location from here, and then so when you choose a documents folder, automatically you can see list of database file name. So from this, let us see, select prod db. So after selecting this, click OK button. Then after that, you can see the screen like this. So after selecting the data source name, so you can see the database name here. So now the database is selected, and then so we have mapped this database prod db with the name my data source. Now you can see our data source name in the user data source. So after seeing our my data source in the screen, you can click the OK button. So far what we have done is we have created one database file prod db with a table prod info. This file is available in the document file, or you can choose any desired location. Next, we have mapped the database file with the data source name my data source in the control panel ODBC tool. After that, we are going to create a database file, and I am going to place that file in C:/Jyothi folder. And to execute our Java program, the JDK tools are available in this location. So we have to use a path command to connect the tool. So to create our Java program, so we have to use either Notepad, or we can use JCreator or NetBeans. So the choices depending upon your facility. Here I have used a JCreator application. Within this, I have created a file, my JDBC. So in this file, I have inserted 5 records into my table. I will explain the program in the next slide. So this my JDBC file contains a Java program with the insertion option. So I have created 5 records. After that, I have saved the file. Next, I compile the file. So if we choose a Notepad application, then you have to compile the file in command window. So since I am creating the file in JCreator, the compiling and executing the file, everything is available in the same editor. So now I am going to compile the program. So for this, I have the option compile file. So I can compile the program. So next, I can execute the program using execute file option. So all commands are available with the single environment. So I am using this. So after executing the program, so you can get the output like this. Press any key to continue. Since we have given the only message like this, press any key to continue after inserting the records into the table. So we have not shown anything in the screen, just we have added 5 records into our prod info database table, and after that it just show the message press any key to continue. So we are getting the result like this. In order to see whether the records are added into our Access, now let us open the Access application. Now you can view the list of 5 records. So these are the 5 records that we have added using our program MyJDBC. So to create a JDBC program, so you have to do 2 things. First, you have to create a table. You have to create a table in any one of the backend application. So in our example, we have used Access application. So after that, move on to the control panel, and then from administrative tool you can get a ODBC tool. So from this ODBC tool, we are going to choose a data source name. So here we are going to map our database file with the data source name. So now the 2 steps are completed. So we have created a database as well as we have connected our database file with the data source name. Then you have to type this Java program, compile it and execute it. Then after that you can view the records updation in the Access application.